Come in.
Hey, Eric. Hey, I want to talk to you about something I found.
How's it going, buddy?
How you doing? Pretty good, pretty good.
You all right? How's work treating you?
No, everything good. Can't complain. Thanks for asking.
Very good.
So I was working on a new design for something new for a company. Mm-hmm. I was thinking about designing a self-driving car with a new style. It's going to be more convenient for people. It's going to be safer. Basically, a new way to be on the road for us as a society, as a country. I had some plans if you wanted to look over them.
A self-driving car, huh?
I think that's really what's going to put our name on top and bring us to be number one.
You know what, Jack? That's why I like you. You came up with these bright ideas. I like that way that sounds. Everyone's trying to come up, you know, with different body styles, different colors, and it's just not doing it anymore. Something like that, something in the electronic aspect of vehicles is, wow, I like the way that sounds. You know what? I wonder how that would do on a market for a projected high paid audience, huh?
Mm-hmm.
That would definitely work. How are you doing, boss?
Hey, Eric, how's it going?
Good to see you, man.
Good, good to see you.
Listen, so we were in the lab, and we were running some tests about the concept car we wanted to run for little cars that can drive themselves.
Yes, yes.
I wanted to show you the different colors and the different body styles that we came up with. So as you see here, we have the red with the black pinstripes. Here's a different style from the side.
Okay.
Different style from the back. We have different colors with white and blue stripes. Our last one, black with a gold silver lining.
Wow.
Just wanted to run it by you, see what you think. You know, everybody in the lab is pretty excited about it. We just wanted to run it by the big man himself, just to see what he thinks.
Well, Eric, I really don't like that. That does not look good. I'm sorry, Eric. I know you're working hard and everything, but, like, oh, man. I need my cars to be looking sexy, real nice. You know, these cars need to be perfect for the people, you know, that I'm trying to market this to. And I don't know if that's gonna cut it, Eric, but I mean, you gotta keep working hard, you know?
Completely
so,
understand.
You know, we wanna market it, we wanna get it out there, and we wanna get this product into the hands of these customers.
No, of course, these nice, the hands of these customers, like exactly.
The nice, sexy, I want to be sexy, Eric.
Okay, sexy, yeah, you got it, boss.
Right, great, Eric, nice seeing you.
Nice seeing you too.
Right, awesome.
Hey, Jack. Hey, listen, bro. He loved the idea. He loved all the colors. He loved all the body styles. Let's set up a meeting. All right, you got it, buddy. See you soon.
What's this? His idea?
No.
Eric, we gotta talk right now.
I see, Jack, what can I help you with?
So I just got the email, which means you just got it too, congratulating you for the idea I gave you, with none of the safety features I proposed.
Well played, sir. Well played. Someone made a mistake and sent you that email by accident. So listen here, buddy. About that email. Everything on it is completely true. I am trying to take credit for your idea. Here's something about those safety features. It doesn't bring the excitement that our projected audience is looking for in our vehicle. So I went ahead and I modified it a little bit. Call me the bad guy, call it what you think. With that being said, I know you're not really happy with this decision. I gotta do what's best for me and my position and where I'm trying to get to. And that means I gotta squash the smaller person. Unfortunately, that smaller person is you right now. So this is how it's gonna go down. I'm gonna go ahead and take full credit, get my promotion. And what you're gonna do now is you're gonna walk out of this office because you're now from this day forward fired from this company. And there's no way about changing that.
So please go ahead, pack up your things, and get out of my office. Jack, pick up. Hello, Jack?
Hello.
Hey, Jack, how's it going, man? It's your old boss.
What do you want now?
Yeah, listen, man, I'm sorry to bother you. I know you don't, you don't want to hear my voice. But, listen, I'm here, on Google, and I'm searching up the concept car you had an idea of, and I see there's an article here. A very nice article that they made about the vehicle you're trying to, I guess, finish up. And I gotta say, man, it looks really nice. I'm very impressed. Listen, I was gonna see if you wanted to come in. Maybe we can shoot a couple of ideas. Maybe get this project finished together. I know we left off on the wrong foot, and I apologize for that. And I'd like to make it up to you. Maybe have this end come out good for the both of us. So, you can have a day to think about it if you need to, but if you like, you can come right in and we can have a little meeting and see if we can put this thing together. So, just let me know, buddy, right?
It's fine. I could be there in an hour.
Alright. Have a good day. Rebecca, can you come in here, please?
Yes, sir.
All right, so I just got off the phone with Jack. Remember that ex-employee of mine?
Yeah.
Okay, so he's gonna be back in about an hour, God willing. I need you to plant this into his laptop. It's a virus. It's gonna fry his whole system. Make sure no one sees you when you do it.
You got it?
That'll be it. Thank you. Tell me. Okay, perfect. Perfect. Rebecca!
Yes, sir?
He's here.
Okay.
Remember, no one can see you.
I got it.
Yes, Detective Perez? Yes, I need you right away.
Something strange has happened.
Eric. Detective Perez, thank you for meeting me on such short notice.
Thank you for referring.
Listen, I found this man unconscious. I wanted to give you a call just to see what you think. Kind of worried about him. Let's check him out. Eric, this man hasn't passed out. He's been dead for hours.
Dead for hours?
Hours.
He has no pulse.
Oh my god. I'll get to the bottom of this, Eric. I will. Miss Williams?
Yeah?
I'm Detective Perez. I'm made you to come with me.
For what?
We have evidence pointing to the murder of Jack Johnson.
I don't know anything about that.
We have fingerprints, we have a lot of evidence, we have video recording, we have cameras, we have everything. We need your company.
Can I call a lawyer?
It needs to be now. A lawyer will be provided for you at the station.
Okay. Just send me grab something.
No, it has to be now. No grabbing anything.
Alright. I'll come.
Alright. Let me tell you what we have a lot of evidence. We have fingerprints on the steering wheel and on Jack's clothes. So you're gonna have to start talking now.
I don't know anything about that.
Ms. Williams, nobody's gonna believe that story. You need to start talking now or we're gonna have some problems.
Okay. Okay, I really was there. But there's a reason I was there. It's because my boss asked me to be there. I'm gonna tell you something, I don't know if you're gonna believe it, but I promise you, I have evidence, right? So, my boss, the guy you saw found in the car, he designed this car, and my boss wanted the designs, and he asked me to plant a virus in the car. And that's why I was there in the first place. I wasn't there to kill anybody. When I got there, he was dead. I just moved the body so nobody would blame me. I didn't want anybody to come and catch me doing anything wrong. That's why my fingerprints were there in the first place.
Miss Williams, I've known your boss, Eric, for many years. We've been good friends for a long time. And he would not do something like that.
I told you, I have proof. This is a flash drive of the virus. It'll show you everything that just happened.
Eric, good morning.
Detective Perez, how are you doing, brother?
I'm doing great. Everything's fine. How's the family? How's the kids?
Doing good, man. Just making sure the wife is picking him up from school, which she is doing so now, so we finally got that headache out of the way. We're good with that. How's everything, man? How are the cases going?
Oh, the cases are alright. Nothing crazy. Yeah, nothing busy.
That's good, man. How about that case that I called you about? How's that going?
I actually come down here to ask for your help on that, because we're having a little trouble with that one right now.
Oh, okay. Is everything alright?
We just wanted to ask you, you know, since you were there and you saw everything, we wanted to ask you about it.
Okay, yeah, not a problem. Anything I can do to help is fine.
Alright, perfect. Thank you. Have a seat.
Got it. Oh, man, what a day. What a day. So how can I be of assistance, Mr. Perez?
Eric, I've been your buddy for many years.
Oh, many years.
Long time. I remember back in high school, we used to play football together. It was crazy.
Way back.
But Eric, I have some bad news today, and I can't help you out with this one. All the evidence in that case, it's all pointing to you.
What type of evidence are you talking about, Perez?
We have call logs between you and Jack. We heard the conversation. You told him to come over. You're the last person he spoke to.
So what are you telling
me? We have someone who's willing to testify against you in court.
So where are we going to, Perez? What's this?
Eric, listen. You're gonna go to jail today, and there's no stopping it. And you only have two options. Either you sign the confession and you have a chance of getting out, or you don't sign it and you're in there for life. I'll give you a minute to think about it, Eric. Go.
Sir, I have something to tell you.
Yes?
I found footage on the company server about what actually happened when Jack died. It wasn't me, it wasn't Eric. It turns out it was the car. Jack must have found a way to make the car completely autonomous. Detective Perez was wrong the entire time.
Well, listen. We already know, we've already seen the evidence, and it's gonna get scrapped within the hour.
What do you mean you've seen the evidence?
This evidence has been out for at least an hour or two, and it went through our servers, so we already saw it. So, you have to understand, I'm the CEO, and I have a way that I run my business. So, we're gonna keep the blame on him, and that's just how we're gonna show it to the public, because if it's any other way, our business will not, it will not be good for the public to understand the truth. So we're gonna have to give them a new truth, because everybody needs something to be angry about, to be mad about, and it's easier for them to be mad at a person. You can get out of my office now.